The Michigan High School Sports Network presents the Class C State Boys Basketball Championship, live from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. Tonight's coverage is brought to you by the Old Kent Financial Corporation, by your neighborhood True Value Hardware Store, and by Farm Bureau Insurance, making your life a little more predictable. Now, with tonight's Class C championship game, here's Rick Berkey and Ed Phelps.
If you're a basketball fan, today is like being a kid in Candyland. Four state championships today decided at Chrysler Arena. We have already seen three champions crowned. Early this morning, Saginaw Buena Vista in Class B. Then in Class A, the championship, of course, went to Terry Mills and his high school teammates. And just moments ago, Detroit East Catholic claimed the Class D crown. But this may be the best game of the day, Rick Berkey, the Class C championship between Saginaw Nouvel and Detroit St. Martin dePorres.
The reason we feel that, both teams won their semifinal contest last night by over 30 points. So as you said, it should be a good matchup. We're looking forward to it.
And a great player playing for Martin dePorres, Willie Burton, who is on his way to the University of Minnesota. We'll be back with a tip-off in the starting lineups for the Class C State Championship ball game on after we pause, live from Chrysler Arena here, the Michigan High School State Network.
Phelps along with Rick Berkey back at the start of the state Class C championship basketball game between Detroit St. Martin dePorres, ranked number one of the state, against Saginaw Nouvel Catholic Central, coming in with a fine 22-4 record. Ready to bring you the announcements of the starting lineup, we go over to public address announcer Howard King.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Welcome once again to the University of Michigan's Chrysler Arena for the final game tonight in the 1986 Michigan High School Athletic Association Basketball Tournament Championships. We have our Class C game tonight between Detroit St. Martin dePorres and Nouvel Catholic Central. Now here are the starting lineups for dePorres at forward. 6'2" senior, number 44, Scott Nichols. Well, forward, a 6'2 senior, 24, Arthel Woods. Forward for dePorres, a 6'6 senior, number 50, George Harris. Well, other forward, a 6'5 senior, number 34, Tom Haley. At center for dePorres, 6'8 senior, number 54, Willie Burton. Nouvel center, 6'7 senior, number 30, Mike Menzel. A guard for dePorres, a 5'9 junior, number 30, Keith Tucker. Nouvel guard, 5'11 senior, number 11, Mark Hammond. DePorres guard, 5'11 sophomore, number 34, Rodney Culver. And a guard for Nouvel, 5'11 and 3/4 junior, number 15, Corey Phillips. DePorres is coached by Ed Rachel. Well, coach is Jim Caridio.
Our officials for this Class C championship game will be Jerry Willis from Mason, Michigan, and Bob Williams from Redford. Don Peck from Traverse City is the alternate. The final championship game of the day. Ed Rachel, the veteran coach, now in his 19th season at dePorres, trying to win his second straight Class C state championship, giving final instructions to his players as the Nouvel cheerleaders urge their cheering section on, and they will be a boisterous one tonight, as Nouvel, dressed in silver and blue, comes out to take the opening tip against Detroit St. Martin dePorres. Jumping for Nouvel, of course, will be number 30, Mike Menzel. And he'll be going up against Willie Burton, the 6'6 7, senior forward who was bound for the University of Minnesota from Detroit, dePorres. The tip won by Burton, and dePorres with the ball. Burton from about 18 feet, shot falls short, but he runs around and gets his own rebound. Keith Tucker, 5'11", junior point guard. Best point guard, according to dePorres coach Ed Rachel, that he's ever had, quickly in the lane for the first foul of the game.
Player control foul, good drive, aggressive, but again, fine job holding his ground defensively for Catholic Central, or should say Saginaw Nouvel, by Menzel.
Tucker picks up the foul. Nouvel, first trip down the floor. Corey Phillips is the point guard. This is Arthel Woods, who's bound for Western Michigan on a football scholarship. Throws up a running shot that goes nowhere. Retrieved by Nouvel. Scott Nichols down the floor, underneath, rebound, no basket, and a foul. First foul of the ball game on Phillips from Nouvel. This will be a good ball game, I think, Rick.
Well, again, we've already got a chance to see the tempo acceleration instantly. Great behind-the-back move by dePorres. Scott Nichols out there at the midcourt line. And going to the line now for a pair is Rodney Culver, the outstanding two-time All-State football player, only a sophomore.
dePorres coming into the game with a 24-2 record. They've lost twice, once to Detroit Murray Wright, the Class A team, and once to Detroit East Catholic, which was just crowned the Class D champion of the state. And we have a 1-0 count following the free throw by the football star Rodney Culver. And he makes it 2. 2-0. Nouvel, no pressure. Burton, however, the last man over the timeline for dePorres. Running a weave, the outside is Nouvel Catholic. Arthel Woods throws up another running one-hander, no good. Rebound by Burton, quickly outlet to Nichols. Nichols far side, pulls up. Got Phillips on him. Passes underneath, great feed underneath to number 50, George Harris, the big 6'6 senior, and it's 4-0.
Great interior pass inside. dePorres already showing great outlet pass as well. Burton ripped off the board and got the whole thing started.
Phillips baseline among the trees, gets the basket and the foul. Foul should be on number 50, George Harris.
Corey Phillips, a 6-foot junior, took the hoop all the way in and drew the foul. You get to see the Saginaw Nouvel fans, as we said, stand the entire game in that cheering section. They're like the 12th man of Texas A&M.
And they'll put up cards and signs and everything else.
Phillips alive with one shot.
Corey Phillips, the junior, 5'10". He's the point guard. He's the only underclassman that starts for Nouvel. 6:32 to go. Just the opening moments of the first period. Phillips misses the free throw. Tip goes off the bottom of the support, and it will go to Nouvel. Knocked out there by Willie Burton. And Nouvel will inbound under its own basket.
Pretty impressive zone that dePorres can throw at you. You know, with Burton and Harris, they cover a lot of ground inside there. It's tough to get it inside, but the Nouvel team does just that. What a fine block, though.
Scrapping for the ball, retrieved by Nichols now. Down the center. We'll get an offensive foul. Nichols realizes he did something wrong. The ball turns over to Nouvel.
On the player control, again, fine position by Nouvel. His first team second, team third rather.
And Phillips with Nouvel, a chance to tie it up. Arthel Woods and Phillips work from near side. Intercepted by Burton. Pass, however, goes behind Nichols and out of bounds. Nouvel will get the ball back. Both teams interested in trying to get the tempo up and get a quick strike and perhaps get a quick advantage in this ball game. We'll watch the turnovers for you. Hannes inside. Good feed. Shot missed. Rebound by Woods. No. Rebounded by Burton. Burton to Tucker now. Tucker quickly up court. Boy, he's quick. Burton pulls up from 18 feet. Short, ball tipped outside, retrieved by Nichols, number 44. And back to Keith Tucker. Ed Rachel likes Keith Tucker.
Nichols all over the court so far for dePorres. On the boards and on the floor.
Pass almost thrown awry, but retrieved by Rodney Culver. Burton comes out the top of the key to get it. dePorres gets it back to Tucker, they'll set it up again.
Nouvel, man-to-man defense.
Yep.
Good, strong, aggressive man-to-man.
underneath Tucker. Knocked away by number 11, Mark Hamas, the 5'11 senior wingman, and he gets called for foul.
Number 11, Mark Hamas, first
Tucker got the pass on into the post position from his baseline. And if DeForest gets it in that deep consistently, Nouvel will have a tough time stopping him.
There's Burton. His shots have not been good to start off here. He's got 2 points, but he's missed on everything else. Nouvel retrieves. They have a chance to tie again. Phillips thought about going inside. Said went to Arthel Woods. A miss. Rebound to Harris. Harris to Burton. Stops. Pops. Yes.
He wanted more than that. He wanted the foul as well, but he did get the basket.
6-2. Phillips trying to get the pass to Hamas. Hamas trips. Ball retrieved by Detroit DeForest. In for the easy layup goes Rodney Culver. He has 4. DeForest has 8. It's an 8-2 ball game. Jim Carideo on the Nouvel bench, following instructions of his team. Didn't want to let it get out of hand here off the start. No Woods. Phillips trying to get it inside. They do to Haley. And Haley gets a bounce. Tom Haley, the 6'5 senior.
Haley, one of the most solid players I've seen in our 2 days up here in Ann Arbor.
Defensive lapse underneath the Burton for the slam jam, and it's 10-4. Burton with 4. Nouvel quickly down court. Offensive foul, use of the elbow, charged on Phillips. The ball will turn over. Into the ball game comes Anthony Fleming, a 6'6 senior, wearing number 40. For Detroit DeForest, and that gives them a pretty good sized lineup up front.
Again, the boards being owned so far by DeForest, and I think that's one of the main reasons they have the 6-point advantage.
Burton out of the ball game on the bench. Ooh, nice baseline move by Scott Tucker. It's a 12-4 ball game. Phillips, Woods, gotta start getting some outside offense. Here's Hamas, goes in the lane, misses a shot, gets the rebound, puts it up again. We get a foul on DeForest. Number 30, Keith Tucker, his second, team fourth.
Good scrappy move by Mark Hamas. Missed the free throw or the jump shot, but followed it in, went in strong aggressively, got the rebound and drew the foul on Tucker. That's his second.
Fourth for the team. So one more and they'll be, Nouvel will be shooting. DeForest hit the last 4 shots. Whoa!
Menzel went up, took Menzel the feed, and he was gonna try and bring it down with emphasis, but.
He was rejected by George Harris.
Saginaw Nouvel, by the way, as we watch the replay here, watch the feed inside.
There's Menzel. And the foul is on Anthony Fleming. His first, team fifth. Menzel goes to the line. Nouvel comes in with a very balanced attack. 24, Christopher Wooley into the ball game for Detroit DeForest. Ed Rachel sending in the subs early. Trying to find the right combination. Menzel hits the first. Very evenly balanced scoring attack as Menzel makes them both for Saginaw Nouvel. It's a 12-6 ball game. Here's Burton back in. Underneath for Tucker. Off the rim. Retrieved by Phillips of Nouvel. Quickly up court. And he'll stop. Wait for everyone to rejoin him. Gets it to Hamas. They weave on the outside again, looking for a spot to get underneath. Phillips pulls it up, knocked away. Tucker behind the back. Great feed to Christopher Wooley. The slam. Hello. 14-6.
What a play by Scott Nichols. Whoa. To set it up.
Standing O from the bench. Timeout from Nouvel. It is 14-6. The score, DeForest 14, Nouvel 6, live from Chrysler Arena. We'll be back on the Michigan High School State Athletic Association Network. Lightning is struck in the form of the offense put on the floor by Detroit St. Martin DeForest. It is 14-6, DeForest over Saginaw Nouvel Catholic Central. 3 minutes to go, first period. Ball tipped away out of the hands of Menzel. It'll go over to dePorres.
Ed, I love the way both of these teams go at each other. They're both playing strict man-to-man. It's like, we're not going to mess with the zone. We're going right at each other. We're going to try and run every chance we get. And right now, DePorres just doing it better. But again, both teams very similar in their attack.
Mano a mano. You do it and I'll do it. And we'll see who comes out the best. That right there was pretty good by Christopher Wooley, who's come in, hit two quick baskets. One, of course, on the spectacular slam following the fine feed. And it's a 16-6 ball game. Phillips finds Hams underneath. Menzel, 2, 16-8. Menzel with 4. Quickly down. I'll tell you one thing about dePorres. They do not mess around. There is none of this slowdown stuff. They are going to beat you down the floor no matter what.
I don't think that a shot clock would have an effect on their game. Foul on Arthel Woods, his first. And fourth team foul.
Shooting foul, but of course to the line will go Scott Nichols, a senior, 6'2". He has 2 points. And a spectacular behind the back pass, too.
That was the pass of the day.
Well, we've had a shot of the day. Now we've got a pass of the day. There are those who claim that DePorres may be the best basketball team in the state. They did beat Buena Vista, which won the Class B title this morning. Shot goes awry, rebounded by Nouvel to the satisfaction of their standing fans, and here comes Phillips, the point guard. Underneath, good move, good feed, Haley in the right spot, he has 4, and it's 17-10 ball game.
Fine pass, but more importantly, Tom Haley got excellent position
yes,
to get
did.
Himself in a scoring situation.
Ham is now on to point guard Tucker. Spin move stole away by Phillips, but he can't retrieve. It's picked up by Christopher Wooley. Wooley and Keith Tucker now. Tucker from 17 feet, yes. He's on the scoring column, 19-10. Woods double teamed in the corner, gets it back out to Phillips. Phillips looking for some help, drives the lane. Drops it off to Menzel. Menzel moves, puts it up, no good. Haley with the rebound and 2, doesn't get the roll. Gets it again, why not?
What a great example of just staying with it. Not being affected by a missed shot. Haley continued to stay right inside, went straight up. Rewarded with his 2 offensive rebounds and a hoop.
Nichols put the shoulder down, but no, the official rules. The foul goes against number 24, Arthel Woods, his second. Should be the 15th foul on Nouvel. Blocking foul is the ball. There you see Nichols takes it back, puts forward.
Good call, good yep. call. He was moving forward. You've got to be completely planted. He had his chest moving forward. Right on the call, our officials that time.
19-12, Tucker goes to the line. Pardon me, Nichols, not Tucker. Misses the first, rebound underneath. Burton got position, goes up, trips, falls down. Ball goes over to Nouvel.
Good example that time by Menzel, who held his hand straight up, realized if he moved at all, he was going to get called for the foul. He stood there like the Statue of Liberty. The result, they couldn't call a foul on him.
Marty Knapp into the ball game for Nouvel, wearing number 14. This is Hamas, difficult angle, but he makes it count. He was almost behind the backboard.
Like he had 1 foot nearly out of bounds.
Tell you. Tucker stops at the top of the key. Teammates underneath waving for the ball. Backing in. Gets it to Burton. Burton looking. Tucker. Gets the bounce. No. Tip. No. Rebound underneath. By Haley. Over the back. The foul will be on number 50, George Harris, I believe.
Harris went to the boards a little too strong. Saginaw Nouvel getting excellent position defensively.
Should be their fifth.
So 39 seconds to go in the quarter. Both teams will shoot the bonus from here on in.
Anthony Fleming comes back in the ball game now for DePorres. Coming out is Keith Tucker. And that'll move Nichols, number 44, to the point. To the free throw line for Saginaw Nouvel is Tom Haley, who's been a force the last 2 minutes of this first period. 6 points. All of them the hard way underneath, too, except for one move. We get a nice pass and drove in for the bucket. Haley makes the first. And Nouvel, which was teetering on the brink just moments ago, is back in this ballgame.
A young people watching get a chance to show how the Haley uses his knees to help his balance here and his motion on the free throw.
High arc, it goes in, and it's 3 point difference, 19 to 16. Haley with eight, leading scorer in the ball game. Scott Nichols now running the point for Detroit St. Martin dePorres. We have Rachel, the coach of dePorres, yelling out instructions on the sideline. Looks like dePorres will play for the last shot as Christopher Wooley and Nichols play catch. Free underneath to Willie Burton. He gets it easy too.
Big people aren't supposed to move that quickly,
well,
Ed.
Well, he does move quick. 10 seconds to go, first period, 21-16. Nouvel's gonna have to press to get that last shot off. Down to three, two, knocked away. Here's Burton, no chance. And the score, Detroit St. Martin dePorres, 21. Saginaw Nouvel Catholic, 16. We are live from the Chrysler Arena. We'll be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network. Ed Phelps, Rick Berkey back live for the start of the second period of play in the Class C State Championship. Saginaw Nouvel inbounds, trailing 21-16 against a very good St. Martin dePorres basketball team in a very good game thus far, the Class C Championship. Menzel misses a shot, ball tipped out of bounds by Detroit dePorres. It goes to Nouvel.
First quarter numbers coming in right now from our statistician Craig Johnson. DePorres 69% from the floor, Nouvel 46. Again, I'm not sure what that was, but that the was leg and arm got caught
that
up.
That was a Billy Sims move. Remember Billy Sims against Houston a couple of years ago when he took that high step, ball tipped away, retrieved by Nichols. Here comes DePorres. They're on the move again. Kind of a control break that time. Ooh, almost steps by Anthony Fleming, but he held it in place. Keith Tucker back in the ballgame to run the point now. Nichols. Here's Burton. Guarded by Menzel. Anthony Fleming. First sub in today. Underneath the Burton. Great quick move. Good balance. Shot short. Knocked away. Retrieved by Menzel. Saginaw Nouvel dressed in blue with the silver trim. Underneath, it'll be a reaching foul. They attempted to get the ball into Haley. Pleading his case on the St. Martin dePorres bench is Coach Ed Rachel. No, that is not the coach. That is a Panther.
That's what that is. Ed, I mentioned again how I think both coaches really are pretty pleased with what they've seen so far. DePorres has to be pleased with 69% shooting from the floor in 21-16. Nouvel doing a lot of things right, just not quite as hot as DePorres is.
Tom Haley, the senior 6'5", leading scorer in the first period. Boy, he puts some arch in that ball, doesn't he? Three field goals, 3 for 3 from the foul line.
None of those free throws have even nicked the rim.
Yes.
Got us a game, Ed.
Yes, we do. 21-18. There's Burton, headed for the University of Minnesota. He's 6'8". They say he's 6'8". Might be 6'7". Nichols on the retrieve makes it count. Nichols with 5 points.
That was the best mistake of the night right there. Burton's pass, a little awry, bounced off a defender's head, went right into Nichols' hands for the layup.
Woods has to come back to help out Phillips. Stops, does not pop, instead passes to Haley, does not get the roll, but Menzel is right there. No foul as players went crashing all over, and Haley is a little slow getting up. In fact, he's not getting up. He really hurt himself when he crashed hard to the floor and tripped over Burton.
And he's in pain, as we can tell.
In pain. And the officials will signal that the bench from Nouvel come over, someone on the bench, to take a look at Haley. Here's the play. Underneath, Burton had tripped. Haley fell over him. And he probably fell on the small of his back, it looks like to me, Rick. What do you think?
Yeah, first of all, an obvious goaltending call missed by the officials there. In fairness to Nouvel, it's just as well that Menzel did get the rebound and score. But of more importance, the collision afterwards with Tom Haley, the leading scorer in the game, and came down kind of funny. It didn't come down that hard, just one of those strange angles. And I thought it was a leg injury of some type below the knee.
We'll get that camera shot back. Well, the official did stand in our cameraman's way. That was the problem, but they had a pretty good angle. It looked like they were looking at the lower leg. I thought for a minute that he had landed perhaps on his back. The small of his back went over Burton, who was already on the floor, but I believe what happened was that he might have gotten that foot twisted up with Burton in the process of falling. And he is going immediately to, off the end of the court, to the athletic training room. They're going to take a look at that one. Putting no weight on that right foot. Tom Haley.
What a factor already in the game. Haley with 10 points.
And he was a force. He was quick enough underneath to get free, and his teammates could find him. So coming into the ball game should be Dave Miller. We'll check the number. Yes, Dave Miller is a 6'3 senior. Now, Miller played a lot when Menzel was hurt early in the season, or in the midway through the season, and played effectively for Nouvel. He's into the ball game now, replacing Haley. And if we get word on Haley, we'll pass it on to you. In fact, we'll try and check it out. 23-20 is the count. dePorres with the ball following the basket that it was awarded to Menzel. Tucker.
Now
Nichols.
With Haley out, Saginaw Nouvel's gone to a zone.
Yes, they have. Immediately started zoning.
Burton took steps.
He took steps. Tried to get a little bit extra there. Now Nouvel, if they're smart and get two on the board this time, can pull to within 1 point. See what they do offensively now with Haley out. Phillips stops, looks for help. Woods goes the other way, pass is thrown away. And the ball goes over to Detroit St. Martin dePorres. One of the players, Keith Tucker, trying to encourage the referee there, probably telling him to look for something. Here's Burton, almost took the step again.
Kind of surprised he had the 15-footer when he turned around.
Didn't take it again. They're gonna force this zone perhaps to work. Oh, great shot. Christopher Wooley, he now has 6-2 in this period. And it's back to a 5-point ball game. Looking for help, Hannes. Missed, no good. Menzel works hard, but Burton has a position. Quickly up the forecourt, Christopher Wooley. He is stopped. And we have a crash underneath. I'll tell you, the bodies are flying.
Goodness gracious. We saw the basketball support almost go down that time.
Heavens to Betsy.
Collision between Wooley and Hammers.
And the ball goes over to Nouvel. Arthel Woods gets the foul drawn on him. And that foul will be against Scott Nichols. 25-24, 59 to go here in the second period of the Class C State Championship game.
Second foul on Nichols, blocking foul committed before the shot. But because dePorres in the bonus, Arthel Woods will go to the line for the 1-1.
Arthel Woods at the line.
Woods averaging double figures, looking for his first point of the game.
Saginaw Nouvel with a very balanced scoring attack. I think they have four players in double figures. Just barely breezed the net and goes out of bounds to Detroit. Martin dePorres on the near sidelines.
That's one that you won't tell about.
Oops. Reach in. On Hammes, his second. Caused Tucker to miss up his dribble and results in a one-on-one situation.
I like the move, though, by Nouvel Catholic coach Jim Caridio going to the zone defense without Haley in there. It's just designed to shake some things up because dePorres was starting to make some progress on the man-to-man offense.
Keith Tucker makes his first. 3 points of the ball game. Jim Caridio, the coach at Saginaw Nouvel, arrived just as the practice schedule was starting. Couldn't find a coach until just before the season. Arrived from Tampa, Florida, where he had been an assistant coach for a JV team down there. Done a great job with his team.
Had to get directions to the locker room.
Had to get directions to the locker room. Probably had to get directions to Saginaw. Nouvel now. Trailing by seven. I think the loss of Haley has affected them. Phillips underneath, and we'll get steps called against Miller.
Good call that time, and again, credit Mr. Burton going inside, going up, intimidating.
Miller was in between. I think he'd been better off if he'd gone straight up, but he didn't know exactly what to do and then tried to put head and shoulders fake and ended up taking the extra step. DeForest now with a chance to build its biggest margin of the day, 9 points, but it's knocked away by Hammes, looking for help, and he finds it in the form of Arthel Woods. Woods cuts his man underneath, and whoa! Heavens to Betsy. That was a foul.
I'm telling you, folks, you go in a layup in this ball game, and you better wear your football helmet.
You are taking your body and putting it in all kinds of problems.
No prisoners taken. If you're going to shoot a layup, you're going to have to earn it.
With a timeout here, the score, Saginaw Nouvel 20, losing to Detroit St. Martin dePorres with 27. Live from Chrysler Arena, we'll be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network. Arthel Woods is going to be a football player for Western Michigan University next fall, so he's used to the contact. He got some there going in for that shot, was fouled, and he is at the free throw line.
It was a meeting of the 24s. They did it up about rim level. Christopher Wooley and Arthel Woods.
Woods gets the free throw, his first point of the ball game.
I want to congratulate Jerry Willis and Bob Williams so far in the game. I think they've done an excellent job. This is, of the games we've seen today, this is probably the most difficult to officiate because of the pace and because of the aggressiveness of both teams.
And that is something that's very unusual. That's twice in this period we have seen a Saginaw Nouvel player miss everything on a free throw attempt. Woods.
And in between, he made a beautiful switch.
In between, he made one. Here's DeForest now. Baseline, Burton. Looking for the ball back, but instead it goes to Tucker. Burton comes out. Good ball movement. Shot put up, knocked away, and retrieved by Menzel. 27-21 the count. Corey Phillips, point guard. Hammes thought about it, changed his mind, dropped it off, intended for Menzel. Gets the second attempt and puts it home.
Good block originally by Harris, but Menzel stayed with it.
Menzel, a comment by his coach, has said he can be as good as he wants to be, which is an indication that sometimes he might not work too hard. But he looks like he's working right now. He's into the ball game. Great rebound of a missed shot by Burton. Hammes brings it up for the Panthers. Tries to go baseline, stops, has the ball stolen away by the quick hands of young Mr. Keith Tucker, the 5'11 junior. Quickly up court comes the Eagles of DeForest. Christopher Woolley has been a factor since he's been in the ball game. He now has 8. Did not start.
Fine-looking left-handed jump shot by Woolley off the bench.
Love those left-handers.
Yeah, but they can't do anything right.
29-23, 2:58 to go, first half. Walking now, I see out of the tunnel, Tom Haley. That is Menzel. He is fired up. He has two, and it's 29-25. Haley coming back, putting weight on that right foot. Not walking at 100%, but looking better.
Talk about double inspiration as Haley walked through the tunnel. Menzel slammed it, and the Nouvel crowd is going crazy.
And with the rebound is Miller. And here comes Nouvel. They can pull it within two. We got ourselves a real ball game. Phillips stops. He loses it, retrieves it. Now we'll set it up again. Woods.
Good decision by Phillips that time.
Yes.
Attempted to take the 18-footer, but he didn't have control and pulled it back out.
Woods, no place to go there. Stops. Miller. Miller. Phillips. Can't quite handle the pass, and that messed up his opportunity to get off a quick 15-footer. Hannes comes out top to retrieve. Now he'll reverse it. Looking for help. Almost get a 5-second call. It was interesting. Was that a dribble off the back? Phillips. Good defense by DeForest. Now Hannes puts it up. Difficult shot. Mark Hannes, he has four.
Both of his shots have been off-balance, acrobatic specialties.
Over in the corner, it's a two-point ball game. DeForest now looking for Burton underneath. Turns, gets the ball slapped away, but will have a foul called.
That was reminiscent of the defense that we saw earlier today on Terry Mills. Got the ball inside to University of Minnesota bound Willie Burton. Defense collapsed all around him and eventually picked up a foul.
Arthel Woods comes out with his third personal coming into the ball game now. Is number 20, and that will be Paul Leake, a 6'1 junior.
Burton, 6 points in the first quarter, first trip to the line.
Burton's been rather quiet. He had the six in the first quarter. Good look at the DeForest bench there.
It's been a lightning quick half. It sure seems like we've got a minute and a half to go.
Good basketball game. Burton makes them both. Nice poised shot. Good balance, good control. Phillips now with Nouvel down by four. Works the left side. Looks for Hammes. Instead, gives it back to Leake. Leake. Phillips. Deep in the corner. No place to go back there. Corey. Try and find Hammes. No? Yes, he will. Hammes heading to his favorite spot. No, now he goes up the middle. Goes amongst the trees. And yes, Mark Hammes. Hammes with six. 31-29 DeForest. 1 minute to go in the first half. Let's see what DeForest decides to do. Looks like they might play catch and wait for the last shot.
Not a bad move by Ed Rachel on the DeForest sideline. The worst he can do really is take a two-point lead in the locker room, assuming his team can handle it for the final minute.
We should get a shot of Rachel resplendent today in sort of a white and red outfit. There's Burton. Burton has the ball knocked away. Stripped by Corey Phillips. 29 seconds to go, first half. Corey, you don't have to put it up now. Almost loses it. Stolen by Hammes. He puts it up. Bad shot, not necessary. He could have waited. Gotten off the last shot of the first half. Instead, here comes DeForest. Quickly in, 4-2 is Christopher Woolley. 12 seconds to go, 33-29, first half. Nouvel trailing. Detroit St. Martin, DeForest Phillips. Oh, almost gets the roll. Gets the foul.
I'm going to go back to about 15 seconds ago after the steal by Nouvel. They trailed by two. The Saginaw bench, Jim Corridio right there, screaming to play for one. He wanted his team to bring it out and kick it out and hopefully get a last-second shot, maybe a tie, still only down by two. But an unwise shot resulted in a DeForest fast break, and now the differential is four, although Phillips has a chance to cut that.
Tucker with his third personal foul, the point guard, so he comes out of the ball game. He is replaced for DeForest by number 34, Rodney Culver. And Phillips makes the first one. Just 3 points of the ball game, but he's been a factor. 33-30, good first half.
Very, very good first half.
Ball short, rebound to Burton. 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Here's Nichols, loses the ball. Won't get the shot off in time. And that is the end of the first half. Great first half in the Class C State Championship game. The score, Detroit St. Martin dePorres 33, Saginaw Nouvel Catholic 30. Live from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor, we'll be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network. Ed Phelps live along with Rick Berkey, halftime state Class C championship, the final championship game on this day of championships at Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. A good ball game, 33-30 if you're just joining us here on the Michigan High School Network. Detroit St. Martin dePorres ahead of Saginaw Nouvel Catholic Central, but this game has got a long way to go.
We certainly got another half of action we're looking forward to. DePorres, of course, associated with basketball excellence. Another name associated with basketball excellence, of course, is Flint Central, coached by Stan Gooch. And earlier today, you, Ed Phelps, had a chance to talk to Stan Gooch about his program and high school basketball in general.
Flint Central coach Stan Gooch, it's a great day for basketball in Michigan, isn't it?
It is, and all the people seem to get together for this one common pastime here in Michigan. You know, Illinois last week didn't sell out theirs, and so we've got a great thing going. It's been that way for the 27 years I've been in it, and when I used to play, you'd come down, and, you know, there's always a lot of people from all over state to get together and share their experiences from the year.
Let me ask you a question that people often ask me. Flint does not have the Class A state champion this year, but nonetheless, Flint has dominated in basketball in Michigan for the past several years. Can you give me a reason why?
Well, they've always had good athletes there. I think probably with the advent of more TV station and the Detroit paper becoming more aware, we're getting a little more publicity, and then we start getting down here, and it's just been a great area, I think, our metropolitan area for athletes, especially 6'4 and under.
You have been around basketball for a few years. Is it as good now as it's ever been high school basketball in the state?
Well, there's more good players, I think. And back when I first started coaching, you know, there were some powerhouses like Pershing, and we had a good team in there, and that Grand Rapids teams, but I think now there's probably 15 teams in the state this year, given the right opportunity with the right luck on some shots, might have won it.
Central made it to pretty far down the line. How are you going to be next year, Coach?
We feel we're going to be very good. We've got a lot of juniors back, and we've got some sleepers. I hope in the JVs are going to crop up a couple more inches, and we'll be representable.
How's your golf game?
Well, I'm starting to pivot without the club. I'll put the club in my hands next week, see what happens.
Stan Gooch, Flint Central coach. Rick?
All right, a couple of golf lovers there, Stan Gooch and Ed Phelps. And I'm not sure who's the better golfer. I hear different tales, but I know that they do get out a lot and play the links. And we do know one thing even more than that, Ed, and that's that Stan Gooch is one of the top coaches in the entire state of Michigan.
Great, great programs at Flint Central. Don't let him get you on the golf course. He'd take care of me. He'd have to give me 7 or 8 strokes, as a matter of fact. Earlier, you know, this is a great day. The State High School Athletic Association Basketball Championships. And it's a day that the association moves in and sort of takes over Chrysler Arena. But what marvelous hosts here we have with the University of Michigan. And Rick had a chance to talk with one of the hosts, the Associate Athletic Director, Don Lund.
Every year since 1975, the boys state basketball finals have been held at Chrysler Arena on the campus of the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor. Don Lund joining us now, the Associate Athletic Director of the U of M. Don, let's kind of briefly summarize what happens when the state comes in and really takes over for 2 days.
Well, first of all, what we like to do is make it a rewarding experience for all the young fellows that come here and play. And so that's the ultimate. I kind of equate it. I've been through a World Series. I've been through NCAA tournaments. I've been through bowl games. And I think at this level, this is the ultimate. And I think that's what we try to do. We have team sponsors that meet the kids, take them to their locker rooms. We try to take all the worry away from a coach. We put the names of the kids on their lockers for souvenir purposes, but everything is based on the fact that it's for the kids.
Now, from the arena standpoint, you've got to clear out the arena twice for it to be refilled again. Talk a little bit about what it means to get the ushers in, get all the workers working together.
Well, what we do, we hold a pre-meeting, and we start with the semifinals, and then we go to the finals, and with our B game starts at 11 o'clock, and after that game, we clear the arena and open it up about 1:30, an hour before the A game, which is 2:30 game, and then clear the arena again and open up for the D and C at night with 7 and 8:30 games. And all the ushers are geared accordingly. Workers come in, we clean the area out, we clean it out twice, and then wait till after.
What's the most difficult aspect of the whole day?
Well, I think after the B game, it's a little rush situation there. We can't quite clean the arena as well as we'd like to. We just don't have enough time. We have more time after the A game is over with. And I would say the most difficult is the cleaning aspects of that.
Well, Don, you're doing a fine job. Keep up the good work.
Well, thank you very much, Rick.
Welcome back. This is the Class C State Championship basketball game for 1986 between Detroit St. Martin dePorres and Saginaw Nouvel Catholic Central. At the half, it is dePorres on a three-point margin, 33-30, as we get ready to start the second half of play. A good ball game, which dePorres, Rick Berkey, built an early lead, but Saginaw Nouvel worked hard, very hard, to stay in that ball game and close to, as we said, just 3 points at the half.
Couple of key players, key factors, I think, in that first off. First of all, Christopher Wooley off the bench with 10 very important points for the dePorres Eagles, helping the team get on top. And Saginaw Nouvel, Tom Haley, for two reasons. One, his 8 first quarter points, keeping his team in the swing, and 10 points over on the half. But the second factor, he goes down with that ankle injury or leg injury of some type midway through the second quarter. Looks very serious, but with a couple minutes to go, he comes back out on the court, and apparently he's doing a little better, although he's not quite able to play yet. He is on the bench. He's trying to walk. He's walking behind the bench, trying to walk off that pain that I'm sure he's had tighten up on him since he went into the locker room.
There he is right there. So he stays on the bench, and Dave Miller, number 22, the 6'3 junior, stays in the ball game as his replacement. 33-30, just underway, third period. dePorres trying to build their margin. Underneath it goes. The basket is good for St. Martin dePorres. George Harris, he now has 4 points in the ball game. Didn't pick up his number, locked out there. Phillips throws it away, Miller unable to retrieve, almost runs into the camera crew.
Very crucial part of the game, especially for Saginaw Nouvel. Now, just down by 3 at the half, they've given up a basket right away, but a team as explosive as dePorres can put 2-3 hoops together in a hurry. You could be down in double digits, and that's bad news against this club.
And it was close to double digits earlier. Burton battling for the rebound, gets the pass back underneath. Ball is knocked away, and we're going to have a foul.
Great no-look pass by Scott Nichols. Snatched the ball from going out of bounds, and watch him whip it without looking right into the hands of Willie Burton.
Nichols is one of the good passers, since we've seen that today. Underneath. Shot up. Burton. Ball almost out of bounds. Here comes Nichols. Retrieves. No look. There he is. Just like it was in the playbook.
Very, very well done.
Traveling call that time against Nichols. Craig, you got that foul. Mark Hammes picked up the foul. Okay, good. Retrieve. Hammes has it now.
Terrific save by Arthel Woods.
Amos hands it off to Menzel, and Menzel, who is into this ballgame with two. And we are down to 35-32. Burton moving on Menzel and gets the easy bucket. Burton's
major league move
today.
That time.
Yes.
By Willie Burton. Menzel held its ground, but Burton showed why he's Division I caliber.
Burton may not quite be as big as they say, though. They say he's 6'8". I don't know if he's that big, but he's quick. He's very quick at his size. Could be a good, it looks like to me, small forward, very quick.
I think he'll be an outstanding forward in the Big Ten.
Yes. University of Minnesota bound. 6:44 to go, third period.
You mentioned Craig Ed, the guy on our right who has just done a whale of a job for us today. Craig Johnson keeping stats.
Had to pick up that foul from Hammes because I missed it. Little pressure now. Phillips dribbles through traffic, loses the ball. He gets called for the trip. To be on number 24, Christopher Wooley. That's his second.
Let's run down the foul situation. First of all, for Saginaw Nouvel, Arthel Woods with 3 fouls, 2 apiece for Corey Phillips and Mark Hammes. On the dePorres sideline, Keith Tucker with 3, 2 apiece for Scott Nichols and Anthony Fleming.
That's Woods. His shot is short. Rebounded underneath by Hammes. Knocked out of bounds. Hammes has picked up his third foul and missed the third period of play. Ball knocked out of bounds by dePorres. It'll be Nouvel, 37-32. They can't quite get over that hump. They stay close.
Keeping an eye on Tom Haley on the Nouvel sideline. He's still working that leg. trying to get back in. You can tell it still hurts him, but it doesn't come close to the pain that he's feeling inside being kept on the bench in the state championship game.
And of course, earlier today, Saginaw Buena Vista won the state championship in Class B without their star, Mark Macon, who was out with a badly injured ankle, sustained in practice just 2 days ago. Here's Burton, shot is way short, however. Phillips, no place to go there, looking for trouble, but he somehow gets through that mess. Makes a pass, knocked away, retrieved by Miller. Miller back to Phillips, scrambly. Arthel Woods up the middle. He can't have a shot, can't buy a shot. Miller reaching, scrambling, kick. Heavens to Betsy, it's a lot.
Look at the scrap in there by Dave Miller. He went inside there and he tried his best to slap it away. Unfortunately, he slapped it to George Harris.
Burton shot missed. Arthel Woods, the backcourt man, in there way up to get the rebound. Still 37-32, 5:35 to go, third period. Phillips. Woods in the corner, no place to go over there. He's trapped. Here we go again. Ball is ruled out of bounds to Nouvel. On his back, number 44, Scott Nichols of Martin dePorres went over the out of bounds line.
Nichols made a fine defensive play getting to the ball, but in hitting the ground, as the coaches love to see his players do, his foot stepped on the sideline.
Phillips looking for help, finds Menzel. Off the glass, won't go. Rebounded almost in Nell's hand. Hammes knocks away from him, but gets control. Here is Woods, no place to go, but he lays it home from about 8 feet. And it's now a three-point ball game.
Woods' first field goal of the day, and he really didn't want to shoot that one.
No, he didn't want to, he was very reluctant. And I see Mr. Haley on the sidelines, ready to come in. Tip, no, Menzel retrieves, ball slipped away, and finally, Woods gets it to Miller and back to Woods.
We've seen more players on the floor in this game than the other three combined, I believe.
Oh, almost picked his pocket clean.
Add another one to the floor.
Did Willie. Here's Arthel Woods. High shot, way short. Rebounded by Harris. Here we go again. A block on Hammes. That is his fourth.
Now, the Nouvel fans are disagreeing, but where I saw it, it was an excellent call. Hammes has got to get the complete body in front of him and have it stationary at the point of contact.
He'll go out. Now, he'll be replaced by Marty Knapp. Also, back into the ballgame, as we indicated, Tom Haley, the 6'5 senior who went out when he injured an ankle late in the first half in a rambly, scrambly play.
Fourth foul on Hammes, and that will really hurt Nouvel.
Marty Knapp, who is a 5'11 junior, in replacing Hammes. Driving down the lane goes Keith Tucker. He has 2 points, and again, it's a five-point lead.
Great penetration by Tucker. He saw the lane, had a gap, took it all away.
Did just what you're supposed to do. Here's Knapp, first shot, short. Haley can't get up. He's still kind of moving gingerly, not quite as quick as he was before.
There's Mr. Wooley again.
Oh, I'll tell you, he came off the bench with 10 in the first half. He lights it up again, and it's a seven-point lead. Steal by Nichols, no. Retrieved by Phillips. Behind his back, stops, doesn't take the 15-footer. Pass it instead for Haley. Haley is fouled by a little number 30, Keith Tucker, and that will be his fourth of the ball game. And Ed Rachel's gonna quickly get him out of there and bring in Anthony Fleming.
You mentioned a little while ago that Haley not moving the way that we're used to seeing in rule, and it was apparent to me on that last play as well. Haley does not have near the mobility he's used to having.
And he's such a big factor for Nouvel Catholic.
Tough decision for Jim Caridio. You know,
yes.
How do you take him out? He's been, you know, one of your main cogs all year long.
41-34, there's Haley. Doesn't get it to go though. Burton gets the rebound. That'll be Nichols running the point for DeForest. Quickly over to Clarence, to Christopher Wooley, and Wooley has 14 off the bench. He is a factor. And it is a 9-point ball game, and Caridio wants timeout. With the score, Detroit St. Martin DePorres 43, Saginaw Nouvel Catholic 34. Live from Chrysler Arena, we'll be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network.
Ed Rachel, the veteran coach at Saginaw, or rather at Detroit, to St. Martin dePorres, resplendent tonight in white and red.
He gets our
second straight Class C championship. Go ahead, Rick.
Excuse me, Ed. He gets our best dressed award, I got to tell you.
Yeah.
Today, he came decked. All he needs is a couple stars on there, a couple blue stars, and he'd win a flag.
Well, it's either he or you. 43-34 the score. Favorite of dePorres slowly edging away from Nouvel. Corey Phillips, they could have used that. They don't get it. Rebounded by Fleming. Nichols, a little bit of a French pastry move there. That is no good, but it is rebounded.
Great tip in by Willie Burton. He was underneath the basket too far, stuck the big left arm out, tapped it in under control. Great
no problem.
Play.
Nichols with a steal. Phillips challenging him, but Nichols going to go all the way. Get the easy layup, and it's now quickly a 13-point ball game.
Nichols, two times down previously, nearly came up the steal. The third time he got it and the layup.
Arthel Woods throws it up. There's a foul underneath. And I think we're beginning to see a little bit too much speed and quickness, and I think the condition of Mr. Haley, number 34, Tom Haley, that is a factor in this ball game. Foul on Harris is second. Rodney Culper, the starter, comes back into the ball game. Well, he's built like a football player, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. And he scored 4 points early in the game, helped his team get off to a good start. Hasn't played that much since, mainly because a young man by the name of Christopher Wooley has come in and been dynamite with 14 points, most on 12 and 15-foot jumpers.
Woods gets one. I'll tell you, he makes him dramatic. High arching shot. Misses that one. Rebounded by Fleming. Culver and Nichols now operating in the backcourt for dePorres. Scott Nichols, number 44. 6'2 senior. Rodney Culver, a sophomore, 5'11. Willie Burton, junior. Hand off. Good pass. Harris converts. He has two. It's a 14-point ball game.
Harris, a fine move inside. When those two, he and Burton, working together, that's a real scary twin tower in there for dePorres.
Haley, shot knocked away by Fleming, goes back into the hands of Knapp, and Knapp gets his first 2 points of the ball game. Marty Knapp, a 5'11 junior. DePorres now, content to just work at an easy pace and get the real good shot. They've got the 12-point lead.
And it's Saginaw Nouvel, which is sitting in that 2-3 zone.
And they've gone in the zone, of course, after Haley got hurt, and they haven't gotten out of it again. Burton, oh my, makes it look easy, doesn't it?
Six in the quarter for Willie.
14 of the game. 51-37. Phillips, Knapp, tries to get underneath for Menzel. Menzel has not been a factor the last 3 or 4 minutes. Woods done a good job on him, Woods and Burton teaming.
He has. We mentioned what they can do offensively. Defensively, they can really create problems with other teams' big man, especially with Tom Haley not being able to be enforced inside and rebounding on both ends.
There's Burton. Thought about it. Decided better of it. Gets it back again. And they take it outside. Burton trying to make a move. He does quickly. Oh, doesn't get the roll, though. Tapped around. Rebounded by Haley. Spike the pain. Got up. Phillips doesn't look for anyone. Yes, he finds Woods, but it's a bad pass and breaks up the timing of the play. 35 seconds to go. Knapp goes left, stops. Back to Knapp in the corner. Head fake, gets a shot, it goes. Marty Knapp has four. They worked hard for that basket, but watch dePorres with 18 seconds to go. They're going to be calm and cool and trying to get one more before the buzzer ends. Ed Rachel off the bench, hollering 1-1-1. Make it one good shot. 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Nichols.
Look for Burton to get it
it. He passes off for Fleming. Outside to Culver. Nichols from about 38 feet. Short. Well, 33 feet. That's the end of the third quarter. The score, Detroit St. Martin dePorres 51, Saginaw Nouvel Catholic 39. Live from Chrysler Morgan in Ann Arbor. We'll be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network. Start of the fourth period of the Class C state championship ball game in gold. It is Detroit St. Martin dePorres holding a 51-39 lead over Saginaw Nouvel Catholic Central. And dePorres, which doesn't need any breaks, makes one themselves, gets the steal, back down for Nichols. A bit fancy there and lost the ball. Burton, great pass. Here's the man who's been the hottest of the ball off the bench. Christopher Wooley with two. He now leads dePorres with 16 points.
On the other end, though, George Harris, the big defensive play, started it off for dePorres.
That he did. That is Arthel Phillips going in there a little bit out of control. I think he's going to pay the price with a foul.
His fourth foul. So now Woods and Hammes with four fouls apiece for Nouvel.
There it is right there. No place to go. Oh, good position by Burton. No doubt about that one.
He could see where his man, that man was going to come in. He jumped to that spot, held his ground, didn't move into him at all. Picked up the player control foul.
Mark Hammes back in the ballgame now for Nouvel.
After that third quarter, big quarter for dePorres. They outscored Saginaw Nouvel 18-9. Through three quarters, dePorres shooting 56%, Nouvel 41.
Burton has his pocket picked. It's retrieved by Phillips. Underneath, he'll drive, no basket. Mike, he'll get a foul. Thought it might be an offensive foul, but it looks like it's going to be against the defense. I think Nichols, who was down at the bottom of the pile.
Scott Nichols picks up the foul. Corey Phillips picks up Scott Nichols.
That's right.
Good sportsmanship shown.
53-39. Now Miller's going to come back in the ballgame. This might signal the end for Haley. Yes, it does. Tom Haley gave it the best, but he is coming out. He is simply not the mobile figure that he was before. After he injured the ankle, he came back, gave it the game try. He had 10 points before their injury, has done nothing since, and really can't get into the ballgame.
And Jim Caridio gave him every bit the benefit of the doubt, gave him the chance. He kept him in there for a few minutes and just realized at a point with 7 minutes left, his team down by 14, we've got to go with five healthy bodies.
And in fact, Haley's not giving up. He's back behind the bench again, walking up and down, trying to get some mobility back in that ankle. So right ankle. Phillips nails it.
Sometimes life doesn't seem fair when you're 17 years old.
Sometimes life doesn't seem fair when you're older. Phillips nails them both. He has five in the ball game. And now we're going to get full court pressure for the first time by Nouvel. But quickly broken. Here comes Burton. Boy, is he quick. Whoops. No harm, no foul that time, I guess, is the ruling. Fleming retrieves.
Oh, did we see a move, though, by Willie Burton coming down on the break, 2-on-1. Might have gotten away with a player control foul there, but regardless, he threw a spin move. Watch this.
Pretty fair 360 coming up here.
Well, Burton got away with a player control foul, but then Menzel got away with a real shot to the snozola there.
And that foul was on Arthel Woods, and he is out of the ball game, folks. That is number five.
He is replaced now by Paul Leek, the 6'1 junior who came in briefly in the first half. 53-41. At the free throw line is Anthony Fleming, senior, 6'6", and he breaks into the scoring column for the first time.
First free throw of the second half for dePorres.
High arching shot, rolls it in.
The Eagles now 9 of 11 for the game from the line.
55-41. Hammis right in front of us. Takes it up. Tries to get it off to Menzel. Stolen by Nichols. Nichols to Burton. Watch out. Burton's had some coaching, though. Rachel says, slow it down, guys. Tells them to run offensive play number 4. They're going to weave it a little bit here. Woods comes out. And Burton. Detroit dePorres. Closing in now in its second straight Class C championship. Burton gets the bounce ball. What a nice soft touch that was.
Almost seemed to take the air out of the ball as he released it.
Burton with 16. Phillips no place to go. Hammis almost puts it up. Drives. No good. Menzel misses. Menzel has not been a factor here either in the second half.
Again, let's credit the dePorres, though. Aggressive defense.
Yes.
If there's one thing I think that's been the overall edge in this game, it's been that consistent, aggressive man-to-man defense. Nouvel played a man-to-man early, but then he went to his zone. dePorres has had more effectiveness against that zone than the man-to-man.
Nouvel back to the man-to-man now. 5:44. You can see that dePorres could play with any team that we've seen today. Would you agree?
I definitely agree.
Even the Class A teams. They could play with a Romulus. They could play with a Detroit Southwestern. They're a good basketball team.
Look at the schooling here. Look at how well they run this delay offense.
There are those that said that dePorres is the best team in the state, bar no matter what classification. And you can see that on any day, they could play with anybody. Scott Nichols, the senior, trying to exhibit a little senior leadership out there, telling Christopher Willey to slow down, calm it down. Burton at the top of the key. Nichols, that's Willie's shot.
He owns the baseline tonight.
I'll tell you, baseline right side, he's got it. He's got 18. 59-41. I think it's just about time. A great move by Phillips for two, but I think it's just about time to find a spot in the dePorres trophy case.
They'll gladly make room.
It'll be a twin with the one they won last year. Reaching foul by Paul Leek, it'll be, and that'll send Nichols to the line, and I think we're going to get a timeout. Yes, we do. With a score, St. Martin dePorres of Detroit 59, Saginaw Nouvel 43. We are live from Ann Arbor. We will be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network. You are looking at the numbers as we have them thus far. Detroit St. Martin dePorres 59, Saginaw Nouvel 43. We are 4 minutes and 29 seconds away from the conclusion of the final game of the 4 championship games in the Michigan High School Basketball Tournament for 1986. This is the Class C title affair, and it is being won convincingly, despite a game effort by Saginaw Nouvel. It is being won by Detroit St. Martin dePorres, which will become the only defending champion to repeat. This is Scott Nichols. He has been instrumental in the play for dePorres. He has but 7 points. Burton with a tip in. Again, misses. Hammis. He's got a man on the left side, but he can't quite control the ball. In fact, bounces it off of his leg, and it'll be double dribble, and it'll go the other way.
On the other end, though, Willie Burton going up strong, almost getting the tap, getting the offensive rebound. A fine block finally by Menzel. But again, the outstanding jumping ability of Willie Burton. Now watch again, watch how they run this delay. They'll spread out, they'll get a double stack low, set a screen, pop another man out to the top, and then do it all over again. Now each time after the man passes the ball in, he'll go down towards the lane, he'll look for a layup.
Keith Tucker back in the ball game for dePorres. He was a starting point guard and a good one, but he's been in foul trouble, so he hasn't seen much action today. Now he's at the top of the key. Boy. Ed Rachel over there telling him, move, move, move. Tucker looking for Nichols, can't find him. Quickly to Leek. Leek's got trouble. He's got Woods in front of him, but makes the try for the reverse layup. No good. Hammes with the rebound. Slapped down by Woods. Put up again by Phillips. He goes down. Everybody goes down. I'll tell you, there has been some banging in this game.
As we said, so many floor burns from this team. Watch the aggressive play here. Both teams going after it.
Burton and Miller particularly. Watch Burton for 54 and Miller. There's Burton over Hammes, knocked away by Woods. Here comes Burton, runs it to Miller over Hammes. Heavens to Betsy, get the football pads out.
Ed Rachel on the DePorres sideline, though, is impressed the way he came out, yelled at his players, don't lose track of what we're trying to do. We're trying to beat the clock.
Number 54 is Willie Burton, the 6'8 senior forward, bound for the University of Minnesota. We're under the impression that he'll be a pretty good college forward.
Folks up in Gopherland have got a treat coming.
Tell you one thing, folks up in Gopherland have had gotten a lot of players out of the Michigan area over the years.
Some dandies. Mr. Shasky.
Yep. Misses. Hammes, ball stripped away. No chance there going through traffic. And DePorres, with 3:30 to go in the ball game, will be content just to, air ball. Burton threw it left, and number 24, Chris Woolley, went right.
Fine catch in the front row by the spectators over here.
Great effort put on by Saginaw Nouvel Catholic, but they just didn't have the horses today. Hammes. Oh, Paul Leek. Holy mackerel. That was a leap by Mr. Leek.
Boy, he came out of nowhere, and I don't know where he's been hiding that one. Certainly gave the Nouvel fans, though, one last big roar.
Reminded me of the slam rebound by the Michigan State forward in the game against Michigan.
Larry Pollock.
Remember that one? That's right. Same end, as a matter of fact. Alan Burton just his second. He'll walk all the way to the other end. Jim Caridio telling his troops what he wants. Ed Rachel.
Well, you're not supposed to leave your seat. I guess he's still seated.
Well, that's a rule that's got to be looked at, I believe. Now, I see nothing wrong with that, but I don't think, according to the letter of the rule, that is legal. That is a technical foul right there.
Technically, I believe you're correct.
And I've seen it called in parts of the state. That's one thing, too, that you have to, you know, if you've got a rule, you're going to call it. Or you're not going to call it. When are you going to change the rule? I think there'll be some adjustments made in that rule this year.
I agree.
Menzel made both of them. He has 14.
But we're going to wipe one away because he stepped on the line as he made the second.
All right, I didn't see that. I was looking down to chalk it up. I was putting it in the scorebook. So it is 60-46. Leek. Oh, he's got great legs. He can move. Hammes has the ball blocked away. Watch out. Burton.
I tell you.
He was all set for the reverse slam.
Lost it on the way up, but by golly, to show you the great athletic ability of this young man, even though he lost it, he somehow threw up a reverse spin layup that went in.
Coach Ed Mitchell's beside himself. He can't believe that happened. Rebound again. Boy's got the good legs. Here we go. Nichols. No slam, just the easy layup. And it's 62-46. It's all over but the final figures now. 2:17 to go. Knocked away. Burton high in the air. Knocked away by Woods. They're going to call a foul. Woods didn't think so. Boy, this is a fine basketball team. Enjoyable to watch. Play enthusiastically, skillfully, determinedly.
Talking with Ed Rachel, he said that I asked him last night, what do you think your team does better than anything else? He says, we play good, strong, aggressive defense start to finish.
Well, they do. There's Phillips. Dishes it off to Miller. No place to go there. Knocked away. From that angle, you can't really tell. Got the ball, obviously, but it looks like he slapped him across the wrist. 2:13 to go in the ball game. We get a timeout as we begin to filter in new players. Maybe, Rick, we can run down the scores of all of the other championship games that we've had today. It's been a long day of basketball.
In the Class B title game, which seemed like an eternity ago.
Just your basic everyday games.
Saginaw Buena Vista on Chris Cole's shot from somewhere between 55 and 60 feet.
I paced it off at 58.
At the buzzer, defeated Flint Beecher 33-32. Not only the most memorable shot that most of the people, including myself, have ever seen in high school tournament basketball, but also gave his team the state championship. Also, by the way, the lowest scoring total in Class B for a winning team in the championship game since 1947.
You're right, I looked that up.
In Class A, Romulus defeated Detroit Southwestern 72-65, the first state title in the history of Romulus High School in basketball. Class D, Detroit East Catholic won it again. Detroit Dave Soles, his sixth state title, defeating Detour 59-39. And St. Martin dePorres about to chalk one up, another one for Detroit. The Detroit schools had two today.
Romulus is not, as close to Ann Arbor, basically. One for Saginaw. What happened to the west side of the state as Miller makes the second free throw?
I knew you were going to bring that up.
Where has been the west side of the street? What is going on over there?
Another good year for the Flint area and Detroit area.
2 minutes to go. Burton. Culver. Back to Burton.
Burton wanted the foul in here. He and Miller are waging quite a battle for position.
Burton's really got the great quick feet. You know that? For a young man, 6'7", 6'8", he's got the great quick feet. Kind of bouncy, very springy.
Yeah, you get the feeling that he's been playing with 10-pound weights throughout the week in practice, and he's just now getting them off.
Boy, and I'll tell you, he's playing so enthusiastically. He loves the game of basketball. You can see it. He loves it.
Even though his team's going to win a Class C state championship, get the feeling he's disappointed. He'd just soon play for another 10, 15 minutes.
I got a feeling, though, give him a year in college and then watch him take off. There's Leak. Shot's short. Retrieves it himself. Tipped away. 3-on-1. DeForest, what's going to happen here? Drop back. Oh, nice feed.
Keith Tucker with a beautiful assist inside.
To Christopher Woolley, and that's probably the first shot he hasn't made from the right side of the baseline. 64-48.
20 points for Woolley unofficially.
Amos tries to dish off, but he gets banged around in there. I'll tell you, we have had more players on the floor, and that's Burton.
And that's a tribute. That's not just sloppy play. That's just good, aggressive play. Anytime the ball was on the floor, you can count on player at least one from each team going after it. Both players, both teams will sleep well tonight.
Yes.
Tomorrow, they'll be sore, but they will sleep well tonight.
Now we begin to get some substitutes in for Saginaw Nouvel Catholic. Coming into the ball game, number 32, that's Chris Karp, and number 33, Jim Morosi, and they replace two of the starters. Corey Phillips comes out. I believe Mike Menzel is out. We get a timeout called by Nouvel Catholic. 59 seconds to go. It is academic. DeForest 64, Nouvel 48. We've got a chance here to banter back and forth. Rick, what's the best team you've seen today?
Well, if I had to pick one of the best four, let's see. I guess I can't say Saginaw Buena Vista with Mark Macon because we didn't see him with Mark Macon. We saw him earlier this year. From what we saw today, I didn't see any team better than this DeForest club we're seeing tonight, right now.
Nice effort by Romulus, which showed it was a fine team and made use of the fact that it had a Terry Mills and made use of him effectively, not only getting points from him, but finding other people because they knew the defense was collapsing on him.
Well, we've got a second. The whole Michigan High School Sports Network program began a long time ago. Some folks put it all together, proposed it, and a lot of work went into it. We hope you folks have enjoyed it out there on the network. And I got a chance to, I want to thank some people that have really helped us out, especially here today. Walter Dell, who takes care of the media up here in the tournament.
That's a great job.
Walter just takes just tremendous care of everybody, and he's done a great job for us. Howard King, the PA announcer over here, who has cooperated and helped us get our numbers and names and done a fine job. You've got a chance to hear his great voice. I always said if I had his voice, I'd be working in New York right now.
I see.
Craig Johnson. Craig Johnson, who's done a great job keeping stats for us. Mr. Vern Norris, the executive director of the MHSAA, again in his final year. We wish Vern the best and congratulate him on a great career with the MHSAA. Our directors, Bob McDowell, Robert Davidson back in the truck, who's tried to keep everybody together on a very, very hectic but important day.
55 seconds to go here in the final game. dePorres 64, Nouvel Catholic Central 49. We'll try to keep you informed as who is in the game right now and what numbers are what. 52 for dePorres is David Greenwood. He's a 6'6 senior getting some playing time. Number 12 is Dana Franklin, a junior. He'll be back next year for Ed Rachel. James Womack is number 10, just a sophomore. There's Franklin off the side, back into the senior. They're just going to eat up the clock, 17 seconds to go. Boy, that's probably doing exactly what the coach said. 32 is Solomon Foster. He's not going to put it up. Underneath, number 52 goes up for the shot. David Greenwood. He is fouled with 5 seconds to go.
Ed, I don't think I have ever seen a team come off the bench that hasn't played the whole game run a spread offense against a team so well.
It really did it effectively. That ball rarely touched the ground. I'll tell you, it was just pass. Ed Rachel receiving congratulations on the sideline.
The whole coaching staff enjoying it.
His second straight state championship for the Eagles. This is David Greenwood. You're getting a good look at him. 6'6 senior. Getting some playing time. And putting his name in the scorebook, as a matter of fact. Nouvel Catholic has nothing to be ashamed about. They did yeoman duty today, but simply were outmanned. Until the injury to Haley, however, they were a major factor in the ballgame, and the issue was not decided. After that, it all became academic. Length of the court, out of bounds, and that ends it. The ballgame is over. Detroit dePorres retains and wins for the second year the state Class C basketball championship, and they do so convincingly. The final score, dePorres 65, Nouvel Catholic Central 49. Live from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor, we'll be back on the Michigan High School Sports Network. And now for the trophy presentation for the Class C champions and runners-up. Here is public address announcer Howard King.
Of the awards in our Class C finals game, Mr. John Duncan, who is the principal of Cedarville-Lishinoe High School and also a member of the representative council of the MHSAA. Mr. Duncan will first make the presentation of awards to our runners-up in the Class C championship, Nouvel Catholic Central. First medal goes to Chuck Williams. Demetrius Madison. Marty Knapp. Paul Leake. Pat Bushy. Dave Miller. Ron Haley. Chris Carp. Jim Morosi. Mark Hammer. Corey Phillips. Marcel Wood. Mike Menzel. And Tom Haley. Obviously, the trophy has runners up in State Class C, Coach Jim Caridio. Now for the medals to the 1986 Class C champs, Detroit St. Martin DePaul, James Womack, Dana Franklin, Jeffrey Collier, Darrell Campbell, Damon Duncan, Christopher Wooley, Solomon Foster, Anthony Fleming, Kevin Burton, David Greenwood, Keith Tucker, Audrey Culver, Scott Nickel, George Harris, and Willie Burton. And to receive the trophy as the 86 champs in Class C, head coach Ed Rachel.
Ed Rachel and his band from Detroit, St. Martin DePorres, receiving the state championship trophy for the second year in a row, climaxing a day-long celebration of basketball in the state of Michigan by winning the Class C state championship 65-49 over Saginaw Nouvel.
Ed Rachel and the Eagles learning what Lofton Green found out a long time ago is it doesn't end, the sweetness doesn't end after the first time. It's just as good the second time, and in some ways even better.
And the coach had a lot of young men repeating the lessons that have been learned so many times on the athletic field, that hard work does pay off with good performances. Ed Rachel going to take time now to join us. Congratulations, coach. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Coach, I understand that you had an assistant coach that very special to the players, and they kind of dedicated the game and their effort in the tournament towards him.
Yeah, Ronald Broughton been with me about 20 years, and he's over here in Ann Arbor with a hip joint replacement, plus he doesn't have any kidneys. He goes on a dialysis machine 3 days a week for the last 15 years. So the operation was pretty tough on him. It was yesterday, and he still don't know what's going on with him because they won't tell us. But we couldn't tell him, your runner's up. There's just no way.
What did you think about the game? Is it tough in the early going?
Yeah, we really didn't play with the intensity defensively that we played last night. And I didn't think we could get out and run like we ran last night. So at halftime, I just made them convince themselves that we're going to win this game playing defense. We were going to get after some people and deny some things. You weren't going to pull away in a hurry. but you could put some distance between them if you stopped them from scoring, get a basket, and deny a basket.
Well, congratulations, second straight championship. Best of luck in the future.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Coach, for stopping by. Appreciate it very much. New Class C champions, not the new Class C champions, the repeat champions from a year ago. Detroit St. Martin DeForest Coach Ed Rachel, 65-49. We'll be back live from Ann Arbor on the Michigan High School Sports Network after this. Detroit St. Martin DeForest, our final champion crowned today, and a great day of basketball, Rick Berkey.
Oh, was it ever. Just quickly, while we got a second rundown again, the champions in Class B, Saginaw Buena Vista, Class A, Romulus High School, Class D, Detroit East Catholic, and dePorres of Detroit St. Martin in Class C.
Enjoyed it very much.
Oh, Ed Phelps, it's been a real pleasure to have you on the Michigan High School Sports Network. We wish you the best of luck. WJRT-TV, we're your sports director. Keep up the good work, and by golly, let's do it again next year.
We'll try. That sounds like a good idea to me.
All right, it's been a lot of fun. Again, thanks to all the folks that made it possible. We hope you enjoyed it. And for Ed Phelps, this is Rick Berkey. Thanks for joining us on the Michigan High School Sports Network.
This has been the Michigan State Class C Boys Basketball Championship, live from Chrysler Arena in Ann Arbor. Tonight's coverage has been brought to you by the Old Kent Financial Corporation, by True Value Hardware Stores. The more you've got to do, the more you need True Value. And by Farm Bureau Insurance, making your life a little more predictable.